नीचे बड़ा कमोशन हो रहा है कि कोई राजनीति मान है तो कोई बड़ा मतलब कोई पर्सनैलिटी का एक लोग ने देखा है वो जितना कह रखा ये थोड़ा सा कमा भाई समुद्र देखने में आ रहा है कुछ ये है ये सब तुमने निजे बस बड्ड बस
मन में मैं कहता था बाबी जी को अगर चौराहे पे खड़ा करते तो गाड़ी रुक जाएगी
अब एक दिन मैं आपको 7 तारीख से हेलो टू यू
आप लोग को मैं सुनाना चाहता हूँ दो रिकॉर्डिंग चाहिए ऑर्केस्ट्रेशन की कमी और सुन
आए सर
आई वुड लाइक टू गिव इट वन टॉक टू अस नाउ 5 मिनट्स सो दैट वी कुड आस्क यू समथिंग सम सॉर्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन आंसर सर बाय 10 मिनट्स नॉट मोर नॉट मोर
आस्क नो क्वेश्चन
यू नो लाइक आई वांट दैट डिपार्टमेंट
ओके भैया सबको बैठाओ
लेट देम सिट डाउन
आई थिंक लेट स्टार्ट दी
या
কোন দিকে বসি বিজয় কোন
দিকে
আমি গোপাল নাম
দিয়াটু
ভি খাতে
আধা ঘন্টা
রেস খেলতে करिए कुछ बात बामन राव जी इमीडिएट फ्यूचर प्लान बैठे हैं बात कर रहे हैं द इमीडिएट मोस्ट You see, we had to record one whole side of an LP, about 21 minutes ka piece. And in the morning, we all assembled a festival of artists, India artists jitne gaye the, wo sab aaye. Aur 10 o'clock was the recording time, no? And while going, up till then we didn't have anything, kya record karne wala kuch pata nahi tha. हम कहे थे कि सब इंस्ट्रूमेंट आ जाना चाहिए स्टूडियो में बहुत बड़ा स्टूडियो एंड 8-track मशीन देयर वर 3-4 तंबूराज और बाकी जो 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 आर्टिस्ट हैं उनके सब एंड जस्ट यू नो वी स्टार्टेड रिकॉर्डिंग विदाउट एनी प्लानिंग मैं सोचा कि थोड़ा ओल्ड स्टाइल का कुछ चीज़ से करें करते करते वो बनते गया चीज़ एंड इट स्टार्ट्स विद ऑल सॉर्ट ऑफ स्तोत्रास थोड़ा वैदिक हिम्स है थोड़ा सा उसमें प्रार्थना है जैसा आप सुनेंगे खुद ही Not a prepared talk, but I will try to make it very informal and just say anything in relation to my music, my travels. Lately I feel a little more confident in our own people, seeing their confidence in me, which has come back. In the sense that because of my being absent for last few years, most of the times abroad, many people took it for granted that, you know, either I have settled down there or I'm mostly concentrating, performing for the Western people, Western audience, and therefore compromising in my music and things like that. Many people went as far as, you know, thinking that I have been sort of trying to commercialize or westernize my music in my performances, trying to please the, as they say and think, trying to please the American audience and the hippies and the pop music-loving crowd. Well, the only things that I did in the beginning, as I have said again and again in my number of articles, that I gave shorter duration of program. But that was in the beginning, as I say. For a number of years I had to do that to make people more accustomed to our music, our classical music.
Today he takes his place, who is the greatest performers of music the world over, with Casals and Rostropovich, with Menuhin Reustrach, with Segovia and Julian Bream, with Richter and Horowitz. If any one of these put down his musical instrument today, he would still be a great musician and a great person. And this is really the test. Ravi Shankar's musicianship and greatness are not limited to the handling of the sitar. It goes far beyond that. But it was through the sitar, the discipline, it was through the discipline of the sitar that he did realize himself fully.
Where you have a great help visually, because the Western music is written down. With us it is very difficult. I mean, as someone said, that Indian music cannot be taught. It can be imbibed. It can be sort of planted. And it needs a congenial atmosphere. It needs a lot of peace in the mind. I personally believe that it's very hard to... You can learn the technique, you can learn the ragas, the arohis and avarohis and the bandishes, and you can have lot of speed, you can... But to make each note alive, pulsate with life and feeling, so that it can move you, just one sa or one gandhar can give that particular feeling of feeling very lonely or feeling very sad or feeling very spiritual or devotional, bring tears in the eyes. These are the things which is not possible to achieve in a year or two. That's why I have been thinking that music should be included in the basic education from the very small age. That's the time when we can really give them the sanskar, as it's said in our country, and to give them sur and lay. People misunderstand me as a sitar player and also me as a composer doing number of other things like orchestral pieces or composing music for films or ballet and such other things. Now, in the field of creativity, one cannot be very much stuck to one pattern, and especially when one has to do music for incidental music for films which are subjects not Indian, one really cannot think of doing purely classical Indian music. Therefore, I have always been very open-minded and I have never been afraid to experiment. Now, I would like you to hear some tapes. The first one is myself playing along with a very famous mridangam player from South, Palghat Raghu. Now I would like you to listen to a piece where you will hear sitar and you will hear tabla, but then all the other instruments are Western instruments. Thank you. piece is from the film Charlie. Now, this final piece that I'm going to play is an experimental thing also, which I call V7½. Sounds very modern, but actually it's very traditional. V is for Rag Vachaspati, and 7½ is because of the rhythmic cycle. This was just a fragment of the things I've been doing on experimental basis. I personally, as you know, belong to a very traditional gharana or school, as it's known, having had the fortune of having had such a wonderful great guru like Ustad Alauddin Khan. I belong to the Beenkar tradition of Rampur, which is a direct descendant from the Mia Tansen, and therefore I am very much aware of my responsibilities, and many people may not realize, but I am in a way very strict, orthodox and traditional person as far as the classical music goes. Gurukul system is one of the greatest thing that has been existing in our tradition, and I sincerely hope and pray that it will continue to exist, because according to our tradition we consider Guru as the greatest emblem for all sort of learning. We respect the Guru at times more than God even, and it is the total surrendering of oneself to the Guru for whatever vidya or whatever art or technique or craft. It could be music, it could be yoga, it could be religious training or anything for that matter. And this feeling of reverence, respect and total surrender helps one to really learn, and with proper sadhana, that is, you know, discipline and work and total humility, one can achieve a great deal.
Guruji, please say something about sadhana a disciple is expected to do.
Well, sadhana is one of our very important things in all fields of art, religion, and sadhana is very difficult to explain in English. It's not just mere work or practice. It's with that feeling of total surrendering to Guru and reverence and dedication and fanatic zeal in working. That's all summed up in the word sadhana. And without sadhana, nothing can be achieved. And that's sort of the message that I have for the young people, is that there's nothing that can be achieved instantly or through the help of drugs or through help of, you know, giving up everything and living a life of giving up just mere wealth is not enough, you see. One has to work hard. Unless one has the sadhana, as you said, nothing can be achieved. So there must be total discipline and proper sadhana. Very difficult for a person like myself, who is insatiable in demanding so much from the life and also at the same time wanting to give so much. I am so deeply grateful to all of you for being here and wishing me for a long and happy life. I'll ask something more from you. I'll ask each of you to bless me so that till the end of my life, till the last day of my life, I can be active and creative. And try to achieve at least half of whatever I would like to, and make all of you really very proud of me. Thank you.